Bringing paint onto brass is a quite difficult job. The metal oxidates very fast, and so it doesn't establish a really good tie on the paint. The deformation of the metal due to the changes of the temperature additionally stress the process of the painting. I've made my best experience using 2C paints, that is two components. An Italian producer of paint offers a dedicated kind of paint for brass. However, a quick test is appropriate in order to be on the safe side. A sample piece got degreased using nitro and split into four parts. Untreated, polished, with and without base coating, one piece gets painted with the airbrush, another untreated one gets sprayed with heavily diluted paint. All pieces got stored 10 times alternately in the summer sun during daytime, 32 degrees Celsius, and in the fridge during the nighttime, minus 10 degrees Celsius. The paint stood its ground on all different surfaces and proved to be very scratch resistant. Now the first parts get degreased into a nitro bath. The coating is applied using an airbrush pistol. Handling the pistol is very familiar to me since I have been working for over 10 years as an illustrator. Thank you. For doing the weathering, I use acrylic paint with the airbrush pistol in mainly three different colors mixtures. For oil and fat, yellow ochre. For rust, red brown. And for dust, as well as traces of water, white light gray. The colors get sprayed and subsequently blurred with different brushes. Thank you. Finally, after the construction period of over 15 months, it's time for the last chapter of this very interesting project, the photo shooting in the mountains. Now, at the end, I feel some sort of melancholy, finalizing such a fascinating project. However, the next big challenge is already waiting for me in my lab.